It's page 3 of the post-conviction denial. In his appeal to this court, petitioner claims that no discovered evidence, undiscovered by trial counsel, who failed to investigate the background of the prosecutrix, warrants reversal of his conviction and a new trial. At trial, petitioner's sole defense was one of consent. Petitioner asserts that trial counsel was ineffective for his failure to investigate the prosecutrix background because of her history of making false accusations, lying under oath, and fabricating injuries would have so severely affected her credibility that the outcome of the case would likely have been different. The district court specifically found that petitioner's trial counsel was not ineffective and stated that petitioner had failed to prove that but for counsel's performance, the result of the trial would have been different. Claims of ineffective assistance of counsel are treated the same as any other issue raised on post-conviction. The claim should be raised on direct appeal, not through collateral attack, or it is waived. I'm giving cites there. Only if the claim is supported by evidence outside of, and therefore not contained within the record, can the claim properly be raised collaterally. In this case, petitioner has raised a mixed claim of newly discovered evidence and ineffective assistance of trial counsel. The two are related because trial counsel's alleged failure to investigate the background of the prosecutrix and